Hello there, in this video we'll cover a subject that I get questions about very often, and this is that people often have the problem of unevenly developed muscles. And this can be that one side of the body is more developed than the other side of the body, but it can also mean that the abdominals are not in a straight line. Most of the time the dominant side of your body is more developed than the non-dominant side, and this is because you will most likely use your dominant arm to perform things that require strength. In this video I will show you a couple of exercises that you can try out to even out the difference between your muscles, although it will take a lot of time to see really good results. And first of all, I will start to show you a couple of exercises that you definitely should not do. So the first exercise is put a heavier weight on the side that is non-dominant. So my non-dominant arm is my left arm. So as you can see here, I am using more weight on the left side. And you can already see how uncomfortable this is and how much my shoulder has to do in order to stay in balance. And for the bench press, this is exactly the same. The left side of my body has to do more work than my right side, but this doesn't mean that it will be more effective. In fact, this will increase the chance of getting seriously injured. The second technique that you should never use is performing more repetitions for the non-dominant side. So again, I do 2 repetitions for my left arm and only 1 with my right arm. And this will only make my left arm more tired than my right arm and will not increase muscle mass on my left arm. So performing more repetitions for one side will increase the chance of getting injured, and it will also only make you more tired rather than giving you any good results. And by far the worst exercise that I could possibly think of is performing individual exercises for the non-dominant side. So here I demonstrate a bench press with only 1 dumbbell. And the only reason why I didn't get injured was because I knew that this was very dangerous and that I used a very light weight to perform this exercise. Then some exercises that might actually help you out, but do note that it will take a long time to see some improvement and that the chance of succeeding is pretty slim, because you will probably always be stronger with your dominant than your non-dominant side. Dumbbell exercises are effective because both sides of your body need to deliver the same amount of force to get up the weight, instead of the barbell exercise in which most of the time your dominant side will overrule. The second advice that I will give you is to perform equal amount of sets and reps for both sides. So don't perform 10 repetitions of barbell curls with your right side and 15 with your left side, because this won't make one side stronger than the other. There are some exercises that you can use to target one side individually, but it is still important to use the same amount of reps, sets and weights. So for example, this is the alternated grip pull-up, and now I'm targeting my left side more than my right side, and I switch my grip and I'm going to target my right side more than my left side. So make sure that you do the equal amount of sets, reps and weights, and this will also ensure that you will have to deliver the same amount of force on both sides. And finally, gain some more muscle mass so you will relatively reduce the difference between both sides. To explain this, I designed this creative piece of art, and example 1 shows you when your muscles are underdeveloped and example 2 shows you when your muscles are more developed. So in the first picture, you can see that the dominant side is almost twice as much as the non-dominant side. And even though the amount of the non-dominant side is as big as the difference is between the non-dominant and dominant side on example 2, the visible difference between both sides on example 2 are a lot smaller than that in example 1. So if you can only lift 10 kilo with your left arm, then don't lift 12 with your right arm, but lift 10 kilo with your right arm as well, because otherwise you will only increase the difference between your muscles. The common question of today is, what is your problem? Subscribe to my channel for more videos, click on playlists to get more beginner bodybuilding basics, tips, and click on my recently uploaded videos for more. Thank you for watching and see you next time!